Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hope you all will be fine and safe. Okay, my dear students, today we will discuss about the topic of chapter number 3, biodiversity. And today my topic is conservation of biodiversity. That first we discuss that what is biodiversity. Different kind of plants and animal species existing on the earth is known as biodiversity. Now we will discuss about the conservation of biodiversity. So conservation means the use of resources wisely is called conservation. And conservation is also defined as the use of resources such as plants, animals, minerals and water in a sensible way. So all these things means that the use of resources wisely is called conservation. And different kind of plants and animals species existing on the earth, that is known as biodiversity. Conservation of biodiversity, the use of natural resources, for example plants, animals, minerals and water in a wise manner is called conservation of biodiversity. And natural resources, for example, we are having a lot of natural resources and wise use of resources. So we should wise use of all these resources which are natural. For example, we should use all the plants in a wise use, in a wise manners. So all these wise use of resources, they are known as conservation of biodiversity. So we should wise use of all the resources. Now, importance of biodiversity. Needs for the present generation, biodiversity plays an important role in need for the present generation as well as for the future generation. It means that plants, they are also need for the present generation and they are also useful. They are also need for the future generation. So we should use wise use of all these resources. Now, steps for conservation of biodiversity. So planting tree. First one is planting tree. Now we following steps should be taken for conservation of biodiversity. First one is planting trees. So we should plant more and more trees, and planting trees means maintenance of the green environment. Next one is conserve forest. We must conserve our forest by wise exploitation of these resources. Environmental laws. Different environmental laws should be designed for the protection of different endangered species. Awareness through media. So awareness through media can be useful in conservation programs. And last one is reduce overhunting. Illegal hunting should be banned because it reduces the population of many rare species. So these are all the steps which are used for the conservation of biodiversity. Now we will discuss about the extinct species, endangered species and threatened species. Now extinct species, a species that no longer lives in an ecosystem is said to be extinct in that ecosystem. For example, dinosaur, for example, rhino. So all these are extinct species. All these species, they are come in the category of extinct species which no longer live anywhere on the earth. For example, extinct species, extinct animals in Pakistan, Asiatic cheetah, tiger, lion, Indian wild ass, Indian one-horned rhinoceros, swamp deer, black buck, hangul, etc. So all these examples of extinct species, extinct animals of Pakistan. Now tiger, lion, Indian wild ass, Indian one-horned rhinoceros, swamp deer, black buck, hangul, Kashmiri stag, endangered, now endangered species. Now what are endangered species? First we will discuss about the extinct species. Now we will discuss about the endangered species. Those species which are less in their population and they are on the verge of the extinction are called endangered species. And we are having a lot of example. And in Pakistan, we are having 31 species of mammals, 20 species of birds, 5 species of reptiles are endangered. Now Indus River dolphin, it is a subspecies of Indus River of Pakistan. It also come in the category of endangered species because these species are less in their population and they are on the verge of the extinction. Also occur in Indus River mainstream and Sutlej, Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum tributaries. only 1100 dolphins are left in Pakistan, and they live in fresh water, and they live approximately 28 years, and they feed on the crustaceans such as catfish and prawns. Next one is long-billed vulture. In Pakistan, it is known as Gith. This species is classified as critical endangered in Pakistan. And geographical range in Pakistan, they are rare in Pakistan. Only colony of 200 to 250 pair was present in Sindh province. Means they are also come in the category of endangered species. They are also less in their population. Marco Polo sheep, they are also in the category of endangered species. They are also found in northern areas. Habitat is steppe valleys and open areas with gentle slopes. And they have long and coil pattern horns, large body size. So they also come in the category of endangered species. Next is endangered species Sobra bustard, also Marhor Capra falconry. According to IUCN red list, Marhor become endangered in Pakistan, and Marhor is the national animal of Pakistan. And Gilgit Baltistan, Hunza, Nagar Valley, Kashmir, Chitral, Afghanistan, northern and central Pakistan, they found in these areas. Now why Marhor become endangered? Because only 2,500 individual thought to be left. In Pakistan, major danger is illegal hunting for meat. So illegal hunting, it is the main cause of the extinction of these species, endangered of these species. Deforestation resulting in loss of their natural habitat. So deforestation is also the cause of the extinction or endangered of these species. Attacked by wild predators and snow leopard, wolf, etc. They also attack on the marhor. So why they are going to be endangered? Endangered species of plants, Rafflesia, Yaw, Chilgoza and Sanobar. And endangered species of animal, Habra bustard, Capra falconry, etc. Now Rafflesia, Sanobar, Yew and grass ferns, they are also come in the category of endangered species. Now next one is threatened species. The species which are likely to become endangered in the near future are called threatened species. And examples are fishing cat, Pallas cat, otter, snow leopard, brown bear. So all these are examples of threatened species. Impact of human being on biodiversity. So inshallah we will discuss this topic in our next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz.